Now, before we start working on Python, one of the very interesting question is, sir, how do you install Python? Installing Python is a very easy task. And as I told that we are working on Python 3.7 version onwards. So I'm going to show you the installation of Python on Windows as well as on Mac for version 3.7 onwards. As well as if you need, I can also install Python 2.7 onwards. I'll show you the installation of both of them so that it will become very easy for you to install Python. So the first and the foremost task is open your Windows and go to Google and now search Python. So let us suppose I want to do Python 3.7. I can just go to Python downloads. So it's a very simple or easy website, which is python.org/downloads. You can easily bookmark this link. You don't have to search Google. You just go to this link and you will see this page. Now here you'll see an option for downloading Python. It says download Python 3.7.3. I'll click on this and it shows it is asking me where should I save. So let us save it on desktop. I'm just going to save it. So it's downloaded. I'll just click it. And this installation menu is now open. I can either customize the installation, whether I can change where I want to install, I can change the path, or I can just do install now. It is very easy. Just click on install now, click yes, and yes, now it is installing Python. It is also installing the standard libraries, as you can see here, and some documentations that are also present. So let's just wait for it to install. It's almost done. Yes, it's installed. So as you can see the message, setup was successful. So you can now close it. And as you can see, now you have installed Python. So you can see here in the start menu, you'll see an option for Python 3.7. I can just go down here. We have Python 3.7 here. So you have multiple options. One is your Python IDLE. Second is Python 3.7, which is 32-bit. So as you can see here, we have installed a 32-bit Python version. I can open IDLE or Python 3.7. Let us open IDLE. And this is the editor for Python. Here you can write your scripts. Here you can write one line of code for Python. So you can see it is very easy to install Python. And just to check, I can use this IDLE or Python shell as a calculator also. I can do 2 plus 3, press enter, you'll see the result 5. I can do 2 multiplied by 3, press enter, you'll see the result 6. I can do 2 divided by 6, press enter, you'll see the result on your screen. So this is Python 3.7.3 on Windows. Now what if you want to install Python 2.7? Just go to Google and search your Python 2.7 download. Click on it. You'll see the first link, which is Python 2.7 release. And it says that Python 2.7.16 is currently available. Click on this available. And you'll see various options here. Okay. And as I'm installing on Windows, I can just take the MSI installer. I'll take Windows x86 MSI installer from here, save it on desktop. So it is downloading the installer, as you can see. As soon as it is downloaded, I'll click on the setup file. So this is the installer here. Just double click on this. You'll see it is asking select whether to install Python 2.7 for all users or for this computer only. Okay. So I think So select whether to install Python 2.7.16 for all users or for this computer only. So I'm just going to click on install for all users. Click next. Click next. Again click next. And now you can see you can install Python 2.7.16. So as you can see on the same system, both 3.7 as well as Python 2.7, both of them can reside concurrently. It is not the case that you have to upgrade 3.7. If you go to start menu, you will see that both you will get options for both of them. You will get options for Python 3.7 as well as you will get option for Python 2.7. Both of them can be present at the same time in Windows as well as in Mac. So I'll just open Python 2.7 ideally, click on it, and as you can see the editor is open, and this is the editor for Python 3.7. I can take this window side by side. Click on side by side. I can take this window side by side, and now you can you know, see the difference between both of them. So for example, here I can do 2 plus 3, that is 5. Here also I can do 2 multiplied by 3, that is 6. But if I do 2 divided by 6 here, it will be 0. But if you see Python 3.7 here, 2 divided by 6 will be 0.3.333 and so onwards. If I do something like this, 6 divide by maybe 4, here the result will be 1. But if you do 6 divide by 4 here, the result will be 1.5. So there's a basic difference between Python 2.7 as well as Python 3.7 that I have already explained. I've created a video on that. So now, as you have installed Python on your system, so we are ready to code now. Okay, so this is the installation in Windows. I'll also create a video for installation in Macintosh. If you have Mac, you can watch that video. Otherwise, you can skip the next video for Macintosh installation.